Views and opinions expressed on Marty's Corner do not reflect those of this cable station, any city cable board, its management, or staff. In fact, they do not reflect my opinion or the opinion of anyone I know. They do not reflect the opinion of the People's Republic of China or the people in the land down under we call Australia. Some of the views and opinions don't even reflect the opinion of Marty. They're just abstract little things that he says to fill time without really thinking about it. The only person with sole responsibility for content on this program is the producer, who, if anything should go wrong or be deemed generally offensive or out of line, will be made to pay dearly. And now sit back and enjoy Marty's Corner.
Live from Hacienda Heights, it's Marty's Corner with your host, Marty Shields. I'm your DJ, Leonardo Flores. Is it an action? Tony Wrigley on tonight's show. Marianne King and Dave Wallach of the 4th of July Parade. Comedian Ed Lobo. Banjo player Andy Rapp. And musical guests, the magazines. And here's your host, Marty Shields.
Wow, that died pretty quickly, didn't it? Take two. Welcome to Marty's Corner as we come to you live, as always, from Hacienda Heights here on a lovely Saturday night. How y'all doing tonight? Come on, get loud. Come on, everybody. Good audience tonight. Again, it's warm out tonight. In fact, as some of you here in the audience can tell, and maybe those of you at home that are watching realize that our old friend Officer Dave is back here with us again. Now, Officer Dave is come onto the show, and of course, with everything going on this show, we have situations where things might happen that are a little bit dangerous for me as the host. We have live animals on the show, or we have dancers, or we have sword throwers, and of course, being who I am, I want to make sure I have a stunt double. So what Dave's going to do tonight, if anything gets a little bit hairy, a little bit crazy on the show tonight, Dave has agreed, as an officer, as security here at Marty's Corner, to go ahead and take charge of the situation and again, defray any kind of bodily harm to me, which is really nice. So he's right there. Dave's going to be watching you. So again, just be aware of that. Dave's here as my stunt double tonight. Of course, a lot of things going on. Of course, it's springtime, and I was doing some spring cleaning last weekend. I was cleaning out my garage. And I found all kinds of lost stuff, like you normally do when you find, you know, you start cleaning out your garage. I found like lost video games and board games. In fact, I actually found Leo's lost virginity in my garage. Yeah. It's all true. It's all true. Scientists report that last Wednesday, just a couple days ago, was the hottest day on the Earth in 400 years. I read this in the news. Hottest day around the Earth in 400 years. Now, Al Gore blamed that on George Bush, too. No. Okay. Thank you. Also in the news, Taiwan has flown in two young male whale sharks in hopes that they will mate with two older female whale sharks in Georgia. And of course, this is going to be happening in captivity. Now, to help the process along, videos of males whales mating are being shown underwater. It's true. Now, the first whale porn they showed was one called Moby's Dick. So, no. Oh, watch out. There's one. You missed it. Okay, wow. Also in the news. Owners of a website called badoj.com, have you heard about this? Claim that the man in the video with the two prostitutes in the hotel room is in fact O.J. Simpson. True story. Now apparently O.J. does believe in practicing safe sex. That's right, he found the missing glove. No, look, that was good. The city of West Hollywood has ordered its police to look the other way when it comes to its residences smoking or possessing small amounts of marijuana. Have you seen it? Yeah? This is true. In West Hollywood, just announced. Now, because of this, the new law, rather, the real estate market there has just completely plummeted. Now, coincidentally, sales of lava lamps, Chips Ahoy cookies, and Visine have just gone through the roof. So, just hit me with it. Hit me with it. I don't care. Okay. I saw that coming 5 minutes ago.
Oh!
Oh, wow. High school sports. High school sports programs are being asked to change their school's mascot names if the names are demeaning to Native Americans. This is true. Now, here locally, La Pointe High School still wants to keep that Indian feel about their name, Warriors. I think they're getting a little bit out of control because they've changed their name to the La Pointe Snake Charmers. Oh, I just... Oh, shit! Man, we believe it or not, we have a good show for you here on Marty's Corner, our 108th show from Hacienda House Live. Believe it or not. Every year here in Hacienda Heights, we do something that's just incredible. We have our own 4th of July parade here in Hacienda Heights. Of course, that's on the 4th of July. And we have two members of the committee who will be on tonight to talk about the parade and some of the things that are going on that day in our community. Our good friends Dave Wallach and Miss Marianne King are going to be here tonight live on Marty's Corner. A comedian joins us. He'll be on just a little bit later in the show. And of course, he plays all throughout LA and Orange counties, and he'll be doing his first appearance here in Marty's Corner. Ed Lobo is here tonight, live on our show. A musical group has come all the way down from, I guess, Pasadena to be with us tonight on a Saturday night. And again, we heard them in soundcheck, and we're very much looking forward to them performing on the show. The Magazines are here tonight, live. And of course, I couldn't do the show by myself. As always, to my left, the one, the only, Leonardo Flores. Leo, take it away. Leo's lost his mind. It's getting hot out there for Leo. In fact, Leo, I noticed that you're wearing a scarf on the show today. Is it kind of hot for a scarf?
World Cup!
World Cup?
USA.
Yeah, no.
USA.
No.
We're going to win it this
no,
year.
No, Leo.
We're going to win
no,
it.
No, Leo.
We're going to win it.
Leo. What? We lost last week, Leo. We're not in the, we're not no longer in the tournament.
Are you serious?
Yes, we're not in the tournament anymore, Leo.
Arsenal!
All right, Leo, fine. All right.
Arsenal!
That's fine.
Yeah.
Thank you, Leo. It's so good to have you back. Or something like that. Our first guest to the show, as I mentioned before, here in the city of Hacienda Heights, we have a very unique event that goes on every 4th of July. And it's been going on for, I'm guessing, 17, 18 years, something like that. It's our own homegrown parade. And we have two members of the July 4th Parade Committee. And they'll be on tonight to talk about a little bit about the parade and what's going on the 4th of July. Can you please give a warm welcome to our show to Dave Wallach and Miss Marianne King. Come on out, folks. Come on up. Have a seat right here, Marianne. Have a seat right there, Stephen. You gonna look that okay? Have a seat right there. Mr. Wallach, pleasure. Have a seat. Have a seat, Dave. Thank you, too, for showing up on a Saturday night.
Well, and I had to give up a hot date and all that. But
did
you know,
you really?
Marty, you're worth it. You're really worth it.
I appreciate you guys coming down, really. I mean, we've been having representatives of the 4th of July Parade Committee on for years and years.
Yes.
How many years now has it been now?
This will be our 19th year.
19th year here.
19th year of the parade.
Now, again, the parade is very unique because you don't see this anywhere else in America, at least not in our areas. Do either one of you know how the parade got started? How did that actually start way back then? Do you remember how that
worked? It was the Kiwanis Club.
Well, it was the Kiwanis Club and the community had wanted to put on a parade. So a couple of the community members from Hacienda Heights Improvement Association, Barbara Fish.
One
of the instrumental
she was
people,
a
Bud
real,
Welch. So some of the community people and the Kiwanis people had wanted to put on a parade. They came to the Kiwanis Club of Hacienda Heights, asked if they'd sponsor the parade, and it's been going on ever since.
And you know they're still involved in the parade very heavily.
To this day, they still are.
Yes,
oh,
they
definitely
are.
We're still at the Kiwanis Club Hacienda Heights is the sponsor of the parade, along with the community committee.
Again, the parade is, again, as I said, very unique. You have all kinds of people from the area coming out, not only to participate in the parade, but also to watch the parade. The parade grows every year.
It does.
The crowds are getting bigger all the time. Do you have any estimation of how many people actually come down and are along the parade route?
Along the parade route, we've estimated about 10,000 of the viewing audience. All the community to come in, and we're actually getting people coming in from other cities. We've got La Puente and West Covina, City of Industry. We've got Miss Taiwan put in an application to be in the parade this year, and they're from Palos Verdes.
And they're coming down just to be in the parade.
Just to be in our parade.
Who's the Grand Marshal this year?
Ken Manning.
Well, guess who?
Ken Manning?
Ken Manning's our Grand Marshal this year.
And you know, Ken Manning and I have emceed that parade together for 17 years. And I know it's been on 19, but the first two I rode in the parade is Miss Marianne from Romper Room, and that was fun. And then Ken and I have been the MCs. But, you know, Ken is going to be the Grand Marshal this year, so that means he's not going to MC the parade with me.
I've heard
this. Alas, alas, I wonder who it's going to be.
I have no idea.
Oh, I do. Yep. I know who's going to be the MC. I brought your hat.
Thank you.
There you go. Because Marty.
Wow. All right.
Wait.
Oh, that's it. Your fan club.
Is that what
there.
That is? This hat is either my head's too big or this just this looks funny on me.
Well, try this one.
Oh, it's the same thing, size, aren't they? Take the other thing away from me.
I brought one for you too.
Now, be honest with you. After I was asked to co-host with you, I'd never done a parade before.
Well, you say hello.
Oh yeah.
We're really glad you all are here. And coming down the street is some wonderful unit.
But there's no script per se. I mean, much like show, we just kind of just...
Well, no, there is supposed to be a script.
Oh.
Everybody is supposed to... Well, we have a parade application here, and it's not too late for all of you to put one in. And here we have the parade application, what you're going to put in the parade, and the information on the back. The trouble is, not everybody puts their information on the back.
So when we announce that group organization coming down, we won't have a lot of background information to talk about.
No, but we can talk about a lot of
So we can just kind of just go as we go.
We ad-lib a lot.
Now this is the official, I guess,
application.
And where can people actually find these, Dave, if they want
to? Well, actually, if you haven't picked up your application yet, you still can go online to www.hhjuly4parade.org.
Right.
You can download the application, and you can fax it either to right here at KCAT at 626-961-7750, or you can fax to 626-336-1071. But if you'd want to take a ride, you can go to New Century Printing on Gale Avenue. They have applications. You could go to the county library on LaMonde. They've got applications. You can go to the Steinmetz Park. They have applications there. It's not too late to get the parade applications in. But we've got to have them by Tuesday because we're putting the lineup together Tuesday night.
And we're meeting right here to do it, the whole committee. But now, anyone can be in that parade. I encourage you all to get involved in what is really Americana. And that's our hometown parade. It is such a joy. Children march with their baseball units. The little baton twirlers come. The bands are there,
right.
The alumni bands from the high schools. Anybody that wants to march in the parade can come. But I tell you what, we could use a few more convertibles. Anybody has a convertible?
They can contact you.
Yes, they sure can.
I believe we have a clip.
Do we have a clip actually of the parade? Let's go ahead and show the parade clip from last year and tell us what we're looking at, Dave and Marianne.
Okay.
Let's watch our monitors here in the control room, of course. What are we looking at here?
Well, that's the kickoff. Well, there's Ken Manning and Miss Marianne, obviously. And then we have one of our entries right here from Wilson High School.
And they've marched in it every year. And then the alumni band members
There's
come
Bud
also.
There's Bud Welch, our equestrian entry every year.
Yes.
Leads off our parade.
And the only requirement to be in the parade is that it be red, white, and blue decor.
There's your very own
Tim Keeler. Well, who is that?
Wow. How that's
And the YMCA Indian Guides.
Yes. Isn't that a great?
There is our Miss 4th of July, Mr. Real Quick. This is the Shilai Temple coming down.
And they have a huge entry.
See that demonstration is going on also?
Yeah.
Well, that was somebody trying to attack you, Marty.
Oh, wow, great. I recognize
this
them.
Is the Women's Club, I believe, coming down. And there's some of our color guards, which this year, all of our color guards will be comprised of Eagle Scouts.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
Which only 2% of all Scouts become an Eagle Scout.
And that was Los Altos Band. And then we have a little band contest at the end of the parade. Now, isn't that cute?
You who think
See what I said?
Everyone's coming down.
Anybody can be in the parade.
Everybody's coming down. Now, last year, we talked briefly about, let me be Grand Marshal. And I guess I didn't make the shortlist this year, but I'm hosting, which is nice because I have more airtime than the Grand Marshal. Because exactly. I know you were thinking that way.
We were. Actually, before we found out that Ken was not going to be able to the narrator, you were going to be
asked. You said that last year.
No, yes, last year we were going to ask you. But then when Ken couldn't be the announcer,
that was the next one up.
You're the very first person we had
to think
of.
But you know what? We've been doing this parade. This will be our 20th year next year. There's still hope.
Is there really?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to go for next year. Then. You also.
But then who would announce with me?
That's true, though, huh?
See, yeah. That's a permanent gig.
That's kind of. See, I'm in a quandary now. I don't know what I want to do.
It's
I want to do both.
It's a permanent gig.
We also have something very special going on for this 4th of July play. Is Miss 4th of July.
That's
now,
right.
Now, tell us a little bit about the contest and how that works.
Well, virtually, we do applicants of all the seniors from the neighboring high schools, La Puente, Roland, Wilson High School, uh-huh. Workman High School, mm-hmm. Los Altos High School.
Right.
Those applicants are brought in. We have a panel of seven who will interview each of those applicants, bring it down to the final three. Then those final three are brought to our Ribfest Scholarship Dinner, where they're interviewed once again by Miss mm-hmm. Marianne. And then the attending audience, which is about 250 this year, actually cast ballots. Who's going to be Miss 4th of July?
And the ballots are counted before the end of the Rib Fest, and the winner is announced and crowned.
And we do have a Miss 4th of July here, don't we?
We yes, certainly we do.
Okay, we'd like to go ahead and introduce you now, the official 2006. Wow, I'm dating myself.
But you know, you have, I'm going to interrupt for just
yes,
a minute, because you're going to tell us goodbye.
Maybe I'll let you stay.
But you know, Ed Lobo is going to be on your show.
Yes, the comedian, yes.
He said I never said his name in my magic mirror, but I already zapped him earlier.
Okay.
And it's always nice to zap you, Marty. And I always have my magic mirror at the parade, so I never let any of you go because they're all still very good doobies.
This is true. Mm-hmm. So we're going to go ahead and bring on right now the winner of the July 4th,
yes.
Miss July 4th here at Hacienda Heights. Can you please give a warm welcome to Kristy Wallach. Kristy, come on out. Just don't mind all the stuff on the floor here. They were booing me earlier. Okay. How'd you get involved in the actual contest, Kristy?
I heard about it through my counselor, the guidance office at my high school, and I filled out the application and sent it in, and then the process went on to an interview and then the dinner, and then I got elected Miss 4th of July.
Did you have to write an essay or something? In years past, didn't they write essays and stuff? Is that part of the... No longer part of the company?
It's just why you want to be Miss 4th of July.
Okay.
More just of a statement, a personal statement, not really an essay.
Now, you've been watching the parade, obviously, for years and years and years. Mm-hmm. Did you think you'd ever be Miss July 4th?
No. In the back of my mind, I always wanted to be, but I mean, there's a ton of seniors in our district, and I never actually thought I'd be Miss 4th of July.
What high school do you go to?
Wilson.
You're a Wildcat.
Yes.
So we're on your campus here. Now, what are your duties entail? What do you have to do as Miss 4th of July?
I have to be in the parade.
Yeah.
I have to go to the fireworks show at La Puente.
The night before?
Yeah, the night before.
Right.
And then I have to attend the concerts in the park and concerts in the past.
And that all happens in a pretty short period of time, I'm guessing?
Yes, basically all just through the summer.
And so you won a scholarship or money toward a scholarship? Is that what the
yes, I won, because I won, I got a $500 scholarship.
Nice. Where do you plan to go for college?
I'm going to Cal State Fullerton and majoring in liberal studies.
Liberal studies, huh? Thank you, yeah. What's the best thing about being Miss 4th of July?
I like being representing my community, and then when I go to places and I have my crown, like the little girls looking at me like I'm their role model.
That's kind of cool, huh?
Yeah.
Now, did you know that part of the stipulation was that you had to appear here on the show?
No, because not always Miss 4th of July appeared. Sometimes it was just the committee, so I wasn't sure.
If you had known, would you maybe have not entered if you knew you had to be here?
No, I would have still entered.
You would have?
Yeah.
Bless you. So again, we want to invite all of you again. It starts at what time, real quick? We'll see right here. What time do we start?
It starts off at 9 a.m.
9 a.m.
at Garside and concludes at Stymus Park. And the parade's finished by about 11:30. Post-parade activities, all kinds of food booths, a lot of entertainment. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, we have a champion roper who attends Wilson High School and is part of the marching band who will be performing at the parade activities.
After the festivities afterwards.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, so again, we encourage all of you to watch the live broadcast, I'm guessing, here on Channel 3 that night, that day. Wow. You know what it is? It's just heat. I think it's the heat.
Now, I'm Marty, just, yeah. You have to be there before 9 o'clock.
Oh, I do?
Yes. Yeah, how about like 7:30?
About 7:30. Okay, I'm going to be there at 7:30, I guess, setting up and talking and such. So, again, make sure you watch it here on Channel 3 at 9 a.m. On July 4th. And, of course, we want to thank, of course, Marianne King and Dave Wallach from the July 4th Parade Committee. Miss 4th of July, Kristy Wallach.
Yay!
We need to go ahead for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back. Don't go away, Leo. Get us out of here.
This morning, I woke up with this feeling. I didn't know how to deal with. And so I just decided to myself, I'd hide it to myself.
Now that's just a stunt. That's not really me. That's Officer Dave. He's my stunt double. So don't clap for him. You can throw things at him, but don't clap for him. Just last week, some of you might know that last year Marty's Corner was nominated for an Emmy, and this year the Emmy nominations came out last week, and we weren't nominated. Well, what are you gonna do? Well, I'll tell you why. What we found was a lot of the shows that were nominated this year were, and rightfully so, were shows that were based on disaster preparedness and things that were more that kind of a genre. And of course, we do something obviously a lot different than that. And we want to make sure that maybe next year we'll get a nomination. So what we're going to do here right now is our attempt to get some Emmy nomination buzz going. So Officer Dave has agreed to go ahead and help us out with that. So we're going to go ahead and go through some quick public service announcements that will, again, hopefully allow us to get the Emmy nomination next year. Earthquakes are very bad. Earthquakes are very bad. And if an earthquake hits, you want to make sure that you either get low, you want to make sure that you're aware of the earthquakes. If you hear it rumbling, if you hear that noise, then you want to... No.
Everybody get out of here.
No. Okay. Wow. Okay. That's fine, Officer Dave. The next one is dogs in the community can sometimes jump the fence and get their way to the street. So if you do see dogs in the street, you want to make sure that you stand still. You do not look intimidating. And Officer Dave will show you again what to do if you do see dogs.
Dogs run!
No, that's not what you do. Going back, Dave. Another one here is, of course, fires. Fires are also bad. And again, if a fire happens in your home and you think you smell something, first thing you want to do is go check the door. Now, you check the door to make sure it's hot. And if you
open, oh my God, there's a fire back
there.
No, Dave.
No, we don't want to do that. We want to be safe. Another horrible thing in the community these days is gang violence. Of course, we have a lot of young kids that are just out of their minds shooting each other for turf warfare. And again, we don't want to do that. We want to be calm at all times and call the authorities. And of course, the last one is a very big thing here in Hacienda Heights is vermin infestation. So again, if you have small rodents that do get into your home, you want to make sure at all times you call the production. And those are Marty's Corner's Emmy segment. Thank you very much. Now, he's supposed to look like me, but I wouldn't act that way in a real situation, so I don't like that at all. Our next guest, is, as I mentioned before, is a gentleman who makes his first appearance here in Marty's Corner, a stand-up comedian, and again, very much looking forward to him performing tonight. Can you please give a warm welcome to our good friend, Ed Lobo. Ed, come on out, Ed!
Thank you. Are you frustrated with me about the gas prices?
Yeah.
Have they gotten outrageous?
Yeah.
I know this for a fact because I just recently got out of my car, went up to the pump, I stuck my gas card in it, and the pump started laughing at me. I kid you not. You've got to put your house up as collateral for your credit line now. I'm serious. Because it cost me $52 to fill up my Vespa. That's a lot of money. But I'm finding ways to get around the frustration. You know, there's so much going on. I'm looking at different things. And I thought the way to do it is health and fitness. It's where it's at. Everybody's doing it. It's good for you. And it's a way to get that tension out. You get to the gym, get on a treadmill, run. I like to create scenarios. I pretend it's my ex-wife looking for alimony. Run, you fat toad, run! It works out great. I love it. But you know, there's a downside to the gym because a lot of people are doing it. It's hard to get on those machines. You got to stand in line. You got to wait. You got to go to do different things. And they tell you, get a trainer. Trainer's where it's at because the trainer takes precedence over everything. But you know, in actuality, if you read the machines, they tell you how to do it. And that's what I did. I learned. So I'm in the gym, I'm trying to get on a machine, I'm looking around, and the only thing I find is this machine called a leg press. Now, are you guys familiar with this machine? You sit in the chair, a little bit of an angle, and you put your feet up on a platform, and you're gonna just push out. And I thought this would be easy. I thought, no problem. Well, I got into the chair, and I noticed the press is right about here. So I managed after 10 minutes to get one leg up there, but I had to borrow the girl from next to me to get the other leg up. Now, after doing this, I noticed that what was once a stomach has now worked itself upwards, and my abdomen and stomach are in my throat. Now, luckily, the instructions are to the right, and I look over, and it tells me, take in a deep breath, and with all of your might, push out on the platform, and at the same time, exhale through your mouth and your nose. So this is my deep breath. When you've got your abdomen in your throat, that's about as deep as you're gonna get. So here I am. Looking like I've got two jugs up top, I take in a deep breath, and I push out. And at the same time, concentrating to exhale through my mouth and my nose. Well, when I pushed out, I exhaled, but it wasn't through my mouth or my nose. That was the shot heard round the gym. Do you know, for the next 45 minutes, there wasn't one machine in a 10-foot radius that I wasn't able to use. Thank you very much. My name is Ed Lobo.
Oh. Thank you, Ed. Have a seat. You know, I've realized that we have been infested with flies and bugs in the studio. Does anybody else see those but me? Yeah. They are everywhere. The only thing is either my jokes are really bad, they're creating all these problems, but most likely, what? I guess the lights are bringing the bugs in. See? And we have the back door open. Yes. We need a screen door here at Marty's Corner, because... Thank you. Thank you. Ed, thank you so much for coming down. How long have you been doing the comedy thing now?
It's been about 5 years.
Now, you said that you recognized Marianne King from when you were a little toddler.
Oh, yes.
You grew up watching?
Oh, yes, I did.
What do you remember about Romper Room?
Waiting to hear my name called.
And it never happened?
No, it did.
Oh, it did happen. I'm sorry.
It did.
Oh, I didn't realize it.
And it was my name. I knew it was about me. My brother said it wasn't. I beat him up.
Good.
No, it was me. And she was looking right at me. I knew it.
Now, have you found out since then how she found out? How did that work in those days? Because I never had my name read. Do you know if your mom called in or a letter was sent? Or how was that? Do you know?
No, I never did find out. And
you thought it happened magically or something?
Yeah, I know it. It was me.
She was looking at you?
We were tuned. We were so in sync. It was unbelievable.
That's why.
I've been watching her for years.
Yeah.
Yes, I was so in sync with her. I knew right then and there. She felt my aura, and it just bop. The name was there.
I can tell some of your routine is kind of Romper Room-esque.
You know, absolutely.
Kind of like like an homage to Romper Room.
Exactly, totally.
I think it's great. Whereabouts are you playing? What kind of gigs you got coming up?
Right now, I haven't. About the last 6 or 8 months, I've been focusing more on training. I've been working with private coaches, writing coaches, improv coaches, commercial coaches.
Wow.
Doing background work on television. Summer's coming up, so I'm going to start working more into the comedy again. But I've been doing mostly background work.
If people want to get a hold of you, what's the best way to contact you?
My website is www.edlobo.com, but it's kind of under construction right at the moment. But you can email me at laughingeddie@sbcglobal.net.
Laughing Eddie.
LAUGHINGEDDIE.
Okay. Again, we want to thank Ed for coming out tonight, and he's going to stay around a little bit, because Ed Lobo, ladies and gentlemen, Ed Lobo, stay right here, Ed. We need to go away for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back. Don't go away. Take us away, Leo. Good, thank God. He looks nothing like me, although he's a snappy dresser. Officer Dave here on Marty's Corner. As I mentioned at the beginning of the show, we have a group of musicians have come down to be with us here on Marty's Corner. And again, heard them in sound check and getting very much looking forward to them performing. Can you please give a warm welcome to the Magazines? Take it away! Right here. That's the best thing about live TV is that these guys actually were prepared, and they're going to switch guitars right now. Tom's going to switch guitars.
Broke a string.
He's going to switch his Telecaster out for an Ibanez. Nice Ibanez, by the way. Beautiful finish. Once Tom gets all ready to go here, we're going to talk to Sarah for just a second while Tom is fumbling with his guitar. How long has the Magazines been together now?
As this band, it's been about... What is it?
8 months.
8 months,
About 8 months now?
Yeah.
And you guys are from Pasadena. Was I correct in my...
Yes.
Primarily in Pasadena. Playing throughout Pasadena, Southern California, where are you guys playing at?
We played at Mr. T's, at Universal Bar and Grill. We've had a couple of loft gigs. And we're playing at Star Shoes in Hollywood on July 5th.
July 5th?
Mm-hmm.
Tom, again, what would you describe your music as? What is it, Tom? It's loud. What is your music, Tom?
It's just rock and roll. We're glad to be on the show because there's a roots here. Hacienda Heights is old SGV, San Gabriel Valley, rock and roll from back in the day. I mean, obviously we're influenced by every decade we've been alive, which is what, 3 1/3? 33 and a third for vinyl enthusiasts. Everything, you know, any good song is a good song.
Who do you listen to? You came in with an MC5 shirt on when you came in today, right? That's an extreme. MC5 was a really hardcore late 60s band out of Detroit. And I'm from Michigan, so what?
We're all over the map, just like you.
Really?
Yeah, Marty, of course.
Oh, yeah, we're going to use this one here because you're getting a lot of reverb.
Oh, sorry.
That's all right, there you go. So again, what are your personal influences? I mean, you're writing something that's completely different than MC5.
Right, well, you haven't heard our whole set. You've only heard one song.
But I have heard your MySpace.
This is true. Well, yeah. Everybody in the band has different influences, and MC5 is a great American band.
Right.
They are an American band from the 60s. There was a time of misunderstanding, of understanding. And then, you know, the 70s has good bands. I mean, it's like you listen to the radio for 20 minutes, you probably hear one good song. And that's the way it is. I mean,
no. As far as the creative input in this band, I mean, do individuals bring in songs themselves, or are you guys collectively? How do you guys work this number?
Well, everybody's friends. I've been writing most of the stuff, but I think, you know, everybody down the line is going to be putting in more stuff because it's a family.
Right.
And I mean,
you don't write the bass line.
No. Leaf has got his own territory. Everybody's got their own territory. It's a great band. We've been friends for almost 2 decades. It's a new band, but this is the first time we've been in a band together, so it's fun.
You're going to be doing another song for it. What song is that going to be?
It's going to be called Tropical Situation.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, the magazines, take it away.
My head is fever, baby, cold as ice. It's just as cold as snow. It's when I looked
into her eyes,
I saw this ocean paradise. It was the ocean blue. Well, my heart just got so hopped up once that girl got knocked up. Tell about it all, oh, baby, I don't know just how to feel, oh, baby, I don't know just what is real. And I'm gonna see the lady, bound to drive me crazy. I got to see her sometime, we'll go out of my mind. Yeah, I tracked that bop for 2 times. Hey, I'm in a black hole. Yeah, baby, that's for sure. When I looked into her eyes, I saw this ocean paradise. It was a beautiful blue. Well, my heart just got so hopped up. If that feels got popped up, well, that girl's with me now. Hey, I'm gone to be there. Baby, I don't know just how to feel. Baby, I don't know just what is real. And I'm gonna see a lady, bound to drive me crazy. Got to see her sometime, let's go out of my mind. Wish she could be here now. I wish she could be here now to see how happy. Put my feet in the sand. Yeah!
Stay right there, guys. Stay right there. We need to go away for a commercial break. Could you play us anything you want, anything out? Just play anything you guys want. Just do the same song. We don't care what you think of a commercial break. We'll see you in just about 3 minutes. Take it away. Go, go, go.
Hey,
here at Marty's Corner, and Officer David is down. They're pelting him with little pictures of whatever the heck these are. Again, the band's going to do one more song for us. Could you, again, welcome to the stage our good friends, the Magazines. Take it away! Before we go out, we want to go ahead and thank all of our guests here in Marty's Corner. Of course, first, okay, we still want to thank our guests anyhow, even though there's 7 minutes left. We'll talk very slowly. And we'll do this. We'll stretch. Ah. Wow. Give me that. Of course, we want to thank our good friend Ed Lobo. Ed, for coming down. Thank you so much, Ed.
Thank you.
And, of course, again, our two guests from the 4th of July Parade Committee, Dave Wallach and Marianne King, for coming down tonight again.
Jeez.
Yep. Watch it here on Channel 3 on the 4th at 9 a.m. And again, I will be co-hosting with Miss Marianne and just looking forward to a great parade. So, again, if you have any questions, contact the committee. Again, if you want to get a float to participate in the parade, The last day is Tuesday for that. So again, if you log on to the KCAT website, that information is available there, which is good for all you folks in Hacienda Heights. We have again about 5 minutes now to kill. Is that Rob? Oh wow! Okay, they're starting to boo me. Officer Dave, why don't you come on over? Come on over, Officer Dave. We're gonna have Officer Dave come over. You stay while you're at it. Officer Dave, come on over here. We're just gonna have him sit there for no apparent reason, because we're trying to kill time. And now the band's gonna do one more song for us. Now apparently this song is instrumental, and the guys have told me they're looking forward to performing this song. They purposely not sang to this song so that it's tight. It's tight as tight can be. This is what I've been assured by the guys in the band. And of course the magazines, to contact them. What's the website one more time if they want to contact you folks?
You can find us on our MySpace page, www.myspace.com/themagazinesrock.
And the next show again is where, Tom?
Oh, that's July 5th at Star Shoes.
And again, and all information is available on your website, right? Correct, if they have any questions?
Marty, we're not going to do the one we practice because heard that Rosie and the Originals, and Rosie's been here a few times. And so we're going to do Angel Baby instead.
Are you really? Are you going to try?
Yeah, we'd like to try it.
Even better yet. Even better yet. Fantastic. Just real quickly, let me set this up for you, Tom. We've been doing the show for about 12 years, and Rosie and the Originals, Angel Baby, has performed on the show many times, and the folks in the band found out that again, she was a friend of our show. I'm just going to lean back. God dang it. And so the folks in magazines are going to do a tribute to Rosie by doing their version of Angel Baby. Again, we'll see you again in late July here in Marty's Corner. So one more time. Wow. One more time. Can we hear it for the magazines? Take it away, guys. Take it away. Cool.